let's take you back to the future, or at least think about the future of blended learning. I know many of you are pondering where we're going. You have questions in your head. Many, many, many questions coming up about blended learning and where it's going. You want some sense of direction, right? We all want direction of where blended learning's going. Maybe it's a gut feel about blended learning, or perhaps you can in fact envision the future. Perhaps you're one of those people that can make the predictions. Well, I'm going to try and provide you with some content for you to think about in terms of blended learning so that you can have a vision of the future and where we're going. Of course, the vision of the future is hard to predict. We don't know exactly where we're going. We do know that mobile learning will be more pervasive. We do know that virtual learning will be more pervasive, collaborative learning, e-books, online lectures. Those are things, components we'll have to consider for our classes and to shift our role from direct instruction most of the time to some of the time, and more coaching, mentoring, counseling, more of teacher as concierge potentially. We might even have blended learning specialists or blended learning degrees, certificate programs for people who become experts at the use and evaluation of blended learning. We might have, in fact, series of mini courses instead of long 15-week courses. We might have shorter bursts of courses, 3-week, 4-week, 1 week, 1 day. And we'll be blending more and more so with our mobile devices that are attached to us, right, for those classes. We'll have to think about emerging technologies because that will change what you can do in terms of blended learning. The types of emerging technologies that will be coming in the next decade, you know, will probably make most courses blended in some way, shape, or form. They will add visual elements to our courses. They'll add hands-on components, reflective components. We'll be mixing and matching those to best suit our particular content areas, to personalize the process of learning for our students. We're going to move from course management systems to personalized learning environments. Part of that personalization is this notion of blending our courses or blended learning. We'll bring in experts like Michelle Ray, who basically revamped the Washington, D.C. schools. We'll bring her in through Fora Television or Link TV or TV Lesson, pre-existing content on the web. We'll be bringing in international experts and global guests and global content. While we do all that, there'll be challenges, of course, that emerge. Challenges for instructors, students, administrators. But this global nature of the content will be one that we have to think about. It will be pervasive. We'll have experts coming in from Antarctica to talk to your students. We'll have people coming in from South Africa, England, Australia, Ireland, you name it, somewhere around the world, we'll be pulling people in. I had an expert last week from Tokyo, the week before, you know, coming from New Zealand, the week before that, coming from the UK and Canada. This is going to be common. When we have that, we'll also have challenges in our blended approaches, because these challenges will be knowing how much, where, when, and why to blend, right? Thinking about that balance between prescriptive kinds of content and the content that might be more freewheeling and spontaneous that you just find 1 week and embed in your class and find it effective for student learning. The notion of choice and self-selection will be balanced by pre-prescribed nature of the content. The role of live instruction, where you might have an instructor coming to you and your class via a webcam technology of some kind, and you pull in that little webcam, right? How much do you need of that live instruction? There'll still be people who don't have access to all the technologies that you have, or this notion of a digital divide. We'll have to take that into consideration, right? And train for new blended formats within your classes. Of course, there are many portals that just emerge, like the Royal Society's new portal of historic papers from 350 years of its existence. Newton, Benjamin Franklin, to name just a few of resources available today. There'll be challenges about documentation. There'll be challenges about evaluation. There'll be challenges about the future and where all this is going. In fact, there'll be challenges every day thinking about the course content, thinking about the wide range in which that content could be made available for other people around the world and not just your class. Think about extreme learning. You know, today people are learning from boats, they're learning from planes, they're learning from mountaintops, they're learning from wherever they are in the world. And this is exciting. I mean, if you could bring someone in from a boat, if you could bring someone in from Antarctica, if you could bring someone in who's in, you know, a grocery store or in a zoo, wherever around the world, we'll have people at, you know, mountaintops sharing their journeys with your students around the world, right? So extreme learning might be blended. We might have simulations, reenactments of plays like Shakespearean plays, expert commentaries. All these things are going to be pervasive in the future. In the future, where are we going? Well, we'll have experts coming into your class. Not only read the articles, but hear from these experts, see them, talk to them, have video wrapped around their content so you're not just reading text. We can have people trying out things in a medical lab or in a trauma unit, right? So that they can experience it, maybe in a Second Life virtual world or some kind of massive multiplayer online game, role play a Shakespearean play or something else, right? The key things are to have a vision for the future. Keep that vision broad because things are going to change. Not everything's going to work. Technologies are going to fall by the wayside and new ones are going to come up. But this notion of blended will not go away. It's only going to continue to steamroll and enter into almost any class. So realize nearly all courses will be blended in some way, shape, or form in the next coming years. Experiment with the blended formats that were talked about in the general program. Experiment with the implementation of blended learning that was talked about in the implementation program. Continue to share those experimentations. You will see that you'll have success. You will see a convergence of those technologies within your classroom settings. And it's important for you today to continue to maybe write reflection papers on your future of your classes, your programs, strategic planning for all this. And then sharing at conferences and sharing with one another what in effect is working best for you. So I hope that you enjoyed this program. I hope you got something out of the program that you can use in terms of the future of blended learning. Keep in mind, this is difficult to predict. These mobile devices will be part of the solution, but just part of it. And each program area, each discipline will have its own solution that you all might rely upon. Good luck to you in the future. Write to me if you have questions. Enjoy your blended learning experiences. Enjoy the future.